The U.S. elections have come a long way in nearly 2.5 centuries. It's hard to visualize the Electoral College, initially made up of 10 states with only 69 electors total, now nearly 8 times as large, with 538 electors across 50 states. Here's how it worked. Each elector received 2 votes. The person with the majority of votes became president, and the person with the second most became vice president. And forget about political parties and massive campaigns. President George Washington was summoned to serve. Think of it as one big write-in ballot. If people saw you as a leader, you were granted the position. It was no contest in 1789. The Electoral College unanimously voted for President Washington. Vice President John Adams received 34 of the other votes. Perhaps the biggest difference between then and now, the public did not get to vote. As late as 1816, citizens of 9 states were not able to cast a ballot, and it wasn't until November 4th, 1845, that the U.S. held its first uniform election day, meaning all states voted on the same day. Still, not all U.S. citizens were given the right to vote until 1965, when the Voting Rights Act was passed. That was just 55 years ago. The legislation ensured all men and women aged 21 and older, regardless of race, religion, or education, the right to vote without discrimination. A tradition continued today where every citizen of the United States over the age of 18 has the privilege to cast a ballot. Perhaps one of the many reasons it's so important to make your voice heard in 2020.